I'm a huge fan of the Grand Theft Auto series. In fact, before, like, I don't know, I was really hyped up for Grand Theft Auto 4 before it came out, and when I used to be an active member of, very active actually, like blogger on game trailers, and I pretty much days leading up to the release, I wrote like each a blog a day about Grand Theft Auto 4, topics relating to Grand Theft Auto 4. I was really excited. So I would personally say I'm a pretty big fan of the series, even though I haven't played too many games of the series. But that being the case, still, I mean, it was hard for me to actually like Grand Theft Auto 4. And it's not because I didn't try hard enough. While the game never ceased to impress me with all its detail and polish, it just didn't entertain me. This is because Grand Theft Auto 4 is something that the previous GTAs are not. Realistic. Gritty realism in open world games like this sure is really impressive, but it also takes away the extreme over-the-top fun that Grand Theft Auto is known for. Grand Theft Auto 4 is definitely not broken, and it is in fact most improved and the most convenient GTA out of them all. But to me, it just lacked the crazy wild flavors of a usual GTA game. From the graphics to the gunplay to the driving mechanics, everything has been changed for realism. Shooting people in GTA 4 feels real due to the newly implemented duck and cover system and destructible environments. Not to mention the physics behind it, which Grand Theft Auto 4 is really proud of boasting, and I have to say it's really impressive. The slow pace of shooting behind cover and moving inch by inch feels extremely realistic and in a way exhilarating, but after the novelty wears down, it can feel a bit repetitive. As for driving, it now feels like Gran Turismo game since, well, I wouldn't go that far, but it does feel more like a simulation than actual like arcade driving that Grand Theft Auto has always been. And that's because you have to brake correctly when cornering this time, and there is a large weight to the cars this time. Now this is cool and all, but there's so many like ridiculous chase missions and required drive while shooting sections in this game that the realistic control scheme can eventually become pretty annoying. Now, realism aside, the game still ended up kind of boring to me. Save for a few characters, GTA 4 is devoid of any interesting people. What this mean? I mean, that was my opinion. I don't know about any other people who I can't speak for other people, but what this meant for me was dull dialogue. Sure, the story of GTA 4 is plausible. Probably the most plausible storyline out of all GTAs, and is probably the most realistic storyline out of all GTAs. But there's a problem when none of the cutscenes are really that entertaining to watch. With the cast that is so ethnically diverse, there's Jamaicans, there's Italians, Russians. I have to wonder why are so many of them without personality, without any flair to be entertained by? And of course, some do have ridiculous personality, like Bruno, that macho guy, but it's very one-dimensional kind of. It's just like you have a character who just have those really shallow, one-dimensional personalities, and a lot of the characters are like that. And the dialogue, the boringness of the dialogue, to me, was really evident, especially near the end of the game. I guess halfway point, because like starting about like 24 hours into the game, 25 hours into the game just feels kind of draggy, and at the end of it all, it's just unsatisfying. Story-wise, GTA 4 has the best thought-up story of them all, but at the same time, it's the least entertaining out of them all. GTA San Andreas, GTA Vice City, or GTA 3 may not have had a cohesive plot, but at no point in those games did I want to sleep through all the cutscenes, in which case I did for GTA 4. The only character that I really got attached to GTA 4 was Roman, Nico's, God, I forgot even how to pronounce his name, cousin. He was a pretty really interesting character, but other than him, I really didn't grow any attached to any of the characters. I was starting to really like. Oh, and the Jamaican guy who has that awesome accent, but I can't really understand him, so I have to read the subtitles for him. He was cool, the weapons supplier. And then the guy who started, he's like a filmer guy, the African American guy who like film stuff. But then he gets shot. Like it was a total shock to me. I was like, holy shit, what just happened? Why? That was crazy. And so the character that I really came to light kind of just died so suddenly. So really, I just didn't have that connection to the storyline, which, you know, to me, Grand Theft Auto, that means, you know, little to me. It kind of motivates me to play the game, but when I'm not even caring about what's going on in the story, I don't know. I just don't feel as attached. But, you know, I still played it, and I got to the end. I found something also very disappointing about GTA 4 after I finished the game, which is that GTA 4 lacks content. There are no bicycles, no airplanes, no crazy weapons, no ambulance missions, no wild cheats, which I don't understand, no real estate, no tanks, no hidden collectibles, and the list goes on. There are a number of assassin missions and pigeons to shoot after beating the game, but there's really nothing fun to do after beating the game. GTA 4 is so realistic, so serious, that they forgot to keep in the things that made the series crazy, and more importantly, fun. I mean, look, the polish in this game is extremely impressive. When you drive through a toll booth without paying, cops will be after you, unless you're in a cop car. If your car gets shot, it will be marked with bullets exactly where it got shot. The characters react realistically to the game's actual time when you call them on your cell phone. These are just few examples of how polished and detailed this game is. But in the end, a game is not only supposed to be impressive, but to give you good, fun time. And on that aspect, GTA 4 kind of failed big time for me. So, overall conclusion is for me is that GTA 4 is the most impressive and the most convenient GTA out of the entire series. But sadly, it was also the most boring one of them all, save for like two missions. The bank heist, amazing mission. I can't remember the other mission, but the one where you go into the hospital dressed as, you know, like the hospital janitor or something. Aside from like those two missions, I really did not have much fun with this game. I haven't checked out the DLC for the GTA 4 games, and I'm not really interested in the Lost and Damned, but Ballad of the Gay Tony looks amazingly awesome. So maybe my opinion on GTA 4 will change after I play the downloadable content, but or the expansions. But just GTA 4 by itself didn't really impress me. Didn't really entertain me. It impressed me majorly. I think it's a masterpiece, but I thought it was a boring masterpiece.